Jim, can you please come up? Jim, your fans, the Rusty Staub Award. Got it? All right. No picture.
I forgot my glasses, so I borrowed someone's here, but I think I can read this. Well, let me start by saying thank you, Adam, for your kind words. It's great to see that you haven't lost your diplomatic touch, a skill we all know has been put to the test over the last month or so. Okay. You know, a big thank you to Larry, the rest of the board, Answer the Call staff for running such an important organization and putting on such a superb event. Obviously, I want to thank my wife, Vivian, Lizzie and Nate, my three sisters, and the rest of my extended family and friends, but also my many Apollo colleagues and the Wall Street partners who really showed up in record numbers to support this great cause tonight. I really want to thank you all. Additionally, I want to thank the firefighters and police officers and their families here in attendance tonight and across the city's five boroughs. It's abundantly clear that the sacrifice those in the direct lines make is true and important to what we operate. Finally, I want to recognize the selflessness and bravery of the spouses and children who share their loved ones in New York City. You should already know this, but you are the real and true honorees of tonight's event. As Larry mentioned, I did grow up in Rochester, New York, actually a small suburb, Pittsford. And one of my first memories is visiting the firehouse of my dad. Big Red loved the firemen. And I think in Rochester and in Pittsford, the police and fire departments were entwined in the neighborhood and the community. And I think that's even true in New York City to a greater degree. I've been fortunate, I lived in New York for over 30 years, and I worked at Citigroup on Greenwich Street, just blocks north of the World Trade Center on 9/11. And I've seen firsthand how the fire and police symbolize the best that New York has to offer. So a few years ago, when Larry asked me to join and get involved 7 years ago, it was an easy decision. You know, Answer the Call's purpose is noble and straightforward. And when I think of this organization, really three words come to mind: community, sacrifice, and fellowship. And these are the core ideals upheld by New York's police and firemen every day. And these same ideals are further preserved by the children of our fallen heroes, many of whom have chosen to follow in their parents' footsteps. In preparing for this event, I learned that 21 of this year's graduating class at the Fire Academy have a parent who lost their life in the line of duty. 13 are children of 9/11 responders, and 4 are with us here tonight. That's a remarkable level of commitment that continues a family legacy. These young adults, who each of whom lost a parent protecting us, have truly answered the call of public service by joining the legions of men and women who risk their lives to help us in the darkest moments. The least we can do is return the favor. And as Adam said, we realize that this organization can never undo the devastation that a family experiences when it loses a loved one in the line of duty. But hopefully, all we contribute and what we organize can help financially, emotionally, with the assistance of which the Answer the Call provides. The collective effort amongst the supporters in this room and those who could not attend is in itself inspirational and gives me confidence when the chips are down, New Yorkers have no peer when it comes to rising to the challenge. I urge all of you who live in New York and have been blessed with resources and great success to bring this event to your daily life. As you walk through the busy crossroads, cross streets, or sit at your office, I encourage you to reflect upon the safety and protection provided in these spaces. I hope Answer the Call may be the avenue in which you honor the lives of these public servants, their spouses, and their children, who our own lives are indebted. Thank you very much, and have a nice evening.